Hello, machinist. Oh, I found Shogo.
What's up, Tomemaru?
Today, I would like to ask about G code and M codes.
Oh, another deep topic. There are many ways to create programs nowadays, but G code and M code are the basic. If you run them well, they will broaden your range. By the way, how is the machine controlled, Tomemaru?
Many machines in recent years are controlled by NC, aren't they?
Yes, dear. It depends on the type of machine, but currently NC control is the most common method, which means the machine is run by numerical control. In our race, there are axes such as ZX and commands are given numerically in the form G00, Z30.0, Z-2.0.
What is this G00?
G00 is a command for fast forward. It's often used for positioning to move the tool closer or away from the workpiece. In contrast, G01 is cutting feed command, which is used to command the feed rate during actual machining. Cutting is performed at the commanded feed rate.
What is a G-code?
G-code is called a general function and is mainly used for commands related to machining. The G00 fast forward command you just mentioned is also a command related to machining and its preparation.
When using this G-code, what happens if another command such as G01 is issued immediately after the G00 command? Does it speed up the cutting feed?
That's a good question. The cutting feed itself won't speed up. It's not possible to execute command for G00 and G01 on the same line. If there is a G01 on the next line after G00 command, it switch from fast forward to cutting speed.
Please explain in more detail.
Okay, there are two types of G-code, so that they varied only once when commanded, one shot, and though that remain varied until another code in the same group is commanded, its model. For example, G04 dual command stops the progress of the program for commanded time, and it's used to prevent the bottom of a groove or hole from being left unmachined. G00 and G01, which were mentioned earlier, are well-known model code. They will remain in effect until another model code is issued.
So you are saying that the model code G00 is being commanded, followed by the one-shot G04 code, and when the dwell is over, the command returns to the fast forward command?
Yes and yes. You've got it all figured out.
By the way, I understand what G-code are, but what are M-codes?
M-code is miscellaneous functions. M-code is mainly used for command to operate a machine. For example, the command to rotate a spindle in forward rotation is M03, and the command to emit coolant is M08. Since M-code are instructions for machine operation, they are often created by machine manufacturer. Note that these M-code numbers vary from manufacturer to manufacturer.
Can I remember anything? I'm worried. What kind of thing do you often use?
Absolutely fine. We all think so at first, but it's surprisingly easy to narrow down the list of frequency used code. There are about 70 standard G-code from G00 to G99. You only need about 16 of these to start with. I recommend you start here and gradually increase the number of codes.
I could understand it from the table, but I couldn't understand one thing. What does constant surface speed control mean?
Constant surface speed control, G96. It's a function that adjusts the rotation speed so that it matches the cutting speed commanded. According to the diameter to be machined, the larger the diameter, the lower rotation speed, and the smaller diameter, the higher rotation speed.
Why is it necessary?
The The cutting speed, the distance, the cutting edge travel when the workpiece rotates for 1 minute. When machining a larger diameter workpiece to smaller diameter, which cutting speed should be set for which diameter?
It's difficult.
Cutting speed adapted to smaller diameter will result in cutting conditions that are too high for larger diameter. A cutting speed adapted to the larger diameter, it will result in conditions that are too low for the small diameter. The goal is to avoid this condition. When using the constant surface speed control, don't forget to command the maximum speed, G50.
What it is? The RPM become too high?
That's what it is. If you cut down small diameter, the rotation speed is set according to the diameter. So it will be turned up a very high rotation speed. That's why we have to set the maximum RPM and make sure it does not exceed that RPM.
I see. I feel confident. Now I have narrowed down the G code from 70 to 16. But can you narrow down the M code as well?
There are about 80 standard M code from M00 to M99, not all of which are used in the same way as G code. If you can extract and memorize only the most commonly used of them, you can create a program. What used to be about 80 pieces of code is now only 22 you need at a minimum. Here it is. Note that in principle, only one code can be commanded per line of the program.
By the way, M00, M01, M30 all seem to be M codes for stopping. Is there any difference?
M00 is a program stop. The program stop progressing there and the machine also pause. M01 optional stop is when the optional stop button on the operation panel is activated, the machine pause. If the optional stop button is not pressed, the machine will continue on. M30 is a program end. It literally means the end of program, and the machine stops. The machine is then brought to the first line of the program, and the same program can be executed by pressing the start button. There is a similar code, M02, but you can remember that it is M30 without initialization function. In fact, this is a point that is likely to appear in Japanese certification examination.
Isn't it hard to remember?
Many machine tools are equipped with an interactive function. We call it conversation function. When you make a product using the interactive function, the screen on the operation panel asks you what kind of shape you want to make. You can program the machine by inputting data in response to the question. If you want to make it even easier, what can you use, Tomemaru?
Oh, I have the answer, 3D Smart Pro AI.
3D Smart Pro is a function that calls the 3D model into the operation panel and automatically creates a program. After a few simple settings, it analyzes the model and generates a program for you. It also suggests machining condition and process sequence. There is no need to memorize detailed codes. Of course, even you are using such function, knowledge of G code and M code will be very useful when you want to modify the machine a little.
I've seen this way of doing things nowadays. It's evolving.
There is no doubt that it is evolving. There are a variety of methods, including manual, conversation, AI, and CAM. But it is the best to run the method that is suitable for you. I think it's best to try various methods and actually use them. Thank you for watching our movie. And if you like this video, then please subscribe and press high rating. See you, machinists. Bye.